My name is Jeff Bouschor, and I'm the Fire Management Officer at the Kenai National Wildlife Refuge. Just wanted to take the time today to engage with you. We appreciate all the interest you guys have had for the Loon Lake fire over the last few days and supporting our firefighters out there on the ground. But I'd like to take some time today to talk to you about some of the bigger challenges we have from a fire management standpoint. We know as a community that we have a lot of fire history here, more frequent large fires that we've been having over the years. Some of the things we've been seeing, right, is that our fire seasons are becoming longer. Climate change is a real thing here on the Kenai Peninsula, and we're seeing that, you know, longer summer, longer seasons. One of our biggest challenges with that is that you as a community are a part of that, and that's what we're tasked with protecting. Is the community. You know, as a wildlife refuge, one of our primary goals is to manage wildlife habitat, but we're also tasked with protecting our communities. And, you know, that's a very difficult balancing act to manage our wildlands, you know, in a place that has, you know, a fairly frequent fire return interval with high intensity fire that bounds right up against our neighbors' backyards. That is challenging. We can't suppress every fire that starts on the Kenai National Wildlife Refuge. There's a number of reasons for that. Some of the challenges are, you know, heavy fuel loading, a lot of fire history in areas that we haven't burned in, you know, 75 years. You know, that creates decadent, thick black spruce forests that, you know, exhibit, you know, extreme fire behavior that really tasks and challenges our firefighters out there on the ground. And some of the problems with that is that, you know, in this day and age, we have more people moving onto the peninsula. We have more homes being built, more infrastructure being built, and more values to protect. And that's challenging. You know, we do quite a bit of pre-planning, pre-season, off-season. You know, we identify areas of concern. You know, we have pre-planned fire management options for the entire Kenai Peninsula. Critical, full, and then backcountry areas of the refuge are identified as limited. And what that allows us to do is prioritize when we do get fires on the landscape. Critical and full are going to get the highest level of response. We're going to take our resources. That's where we're going to go, and we're going to respond. And we want those fires to be put out the smallest size possible with the least amount of impact to our communities. You know, limited fires are just our lower priority. It's not that that we don't suppress those fires. As you've seen with Loon Lake this week, you know, we had a great opportunity to suppress a fire because of the time of year. We felt like it was really early in the season to potentially have a fire burning out and limited. There were resources available for us. There was not, you know, a lot of fires going on statewide. So there were plenty of resources available for us to choose the strategy that we did, and that allowed us to, you know, to go full suppression. Even though there weren't direct values at risk, we felt like the long-term benefit of suppressing that fire at this point in time was the right decision to make. Kenai National Wildlife Refuge, in partnership with the Kenai Peninsula Borough, Chagachmeuk Corporation, Alaska Department of Forestry, we've been working for quite a few years now on the Sterling fuel break. We started a fuel break process on the refuge. We've been continuing on for a number of years. We've actually completed the fuel break all to the north of the community of Sterling, and plans are underway to continue working with our partners, moving our way north, continuing to move towards Nikiski. It's just been an ongoing effort that we have been working on with a great collaborative effort with all of our partners. We feel that the fuel break project is one of the key lines of defense that we have for fire coming off the refuge that may potentially impact our communities.
I'm Dan Nelson, the Emergency Manager for the Kenai Peninsula Borough. Emergency management is a result of partnerships. On the Kenai Peninsula, we've had the fortune to be able to work with all landowners, such as the Kenai National Wildlife Refuge, the state, Native associations, and many others, to be able to ensure that we're doing coordinated mitigation efforts. That mitigation, as well as the work from private landowners making sure that their properties are firewise, they have defensible space, really makes the job of the firefighters easier, but also makes the process of large-scale emergency management work to everybody's benefit.
Fire will happen on the refuge, but the reality is we have a lot of human-caused fires, and those fires start in people's backyards, along roadways, on power lines, and our firefighters, and we ask you to embrace FireWise principles. Clean up around your house, remove flammable vegetation, you know, provide defensible space. When our firefighters go out and respond to a fire and they show up, it's quite clear if the landowners and the property owners have taken the time and prepared their area to be fire resilient, be fire adapted, where our firefighters can go in and respond and feel safe about being there and still do good work and suppress the fire, we're able to be more efficient. Our firefighters are able to be more safe. That way we can move on, we can protect more properties, and we can more quickly and easily suppress fires in those areas that we're concerned about within your communities. There's a number of resources out there and available for you as a homeowner, as a private property owner, to dispose of your slash as you clean up your property while you're investing in FireWise principles on your property.
My name is Drew Anderson. I work for Division of Forestry, Kenai Kodiak Area Office. I'm a prevention technician here. We encourage the public to firewise their home to be safe in case a wildfire does occur near your home. And disposal of that slash, you could use the local landfill. They can dispose of it for you. I'm going to briefly discuss some of the regulations that are required between April 1st and August 31st. Such as having water on scene, always being in attendance of your fire, and make sure you're going to fully extinguish that fire when you're done burning. We kind of recommend people burn slash in the winter months where escapement won't happen. But if you do choose to burn during the summer months, following the regulations in the burn permit will keep you safe and legal.
Thank you for your time today. Really appreciate the level of interest you guys have been providing to us this past week. Just want to say that as we start to slow down, as the Loon Lake fire starts to slow down, just remember that it's, you know, our fire season is still quite young. You know, we have potential, you know, throughout the summer at any point in time to have, you know, large fires or mini fires here on the peninsula. I ask you to be prepared, be engaged, and work with us. Remember that we're all in this together. It's not just the land management agencies, it's us working with our communities to be fire adapted.